people. I'm Ginny Metheral. I'm a fourth generation witch and I live in the wilds of Devon, which is south of the UK, where I practice traditional witchcraft. I've been often asked whether I follow a daily witchy routine, a daily morning routine, and the answer is yes, I do. However, I have looked at a couple of witchy morning routines on YouTube and mine is not like those. I've been a bit hesitant about sharing with YouTube my witchy routine because it's a bit different and not like other people's, and I'm not sure that you're going to think that I am one sandwich short of a picnic, which maybe I am. So I'm going to show you what I do each morning when I wake up. I wake up fairly early each morning, anywhere between 5:30 to 6:30. I have to get out of bed at 6:45 in order to start my day properly. But I do like to have a little time to myself in the morning before the house awakes. Now my husband, happily, gets up extremely early too, but he normally gets up and goes downstairs and starts fiddling with coffee. So I wake up quite slowly, and I always have my curtains open. I never draw my curtains at night. And this is simply so that I can see the moon and see the stars, which I very much enjoy doing whilst lying in bed, and then see the day as it arises, especially when you wake up so early, you get the dawn, and that's something I really enjoy, opening my eyes to the dawn each morning. So far, so normal. The very first thing I tend to do when I have woken up is to try and recall any dreams that I have had and write them down in my book. This is a really important ritual for me. There is a difference between dreams which are just, you know, your imagination cruising about at night, and dreams which have a certain prophetic tone to them, which mine often do. The difference between the dreams is that A, they're much more vivid than a normal dream and very clear. I can often remember them. B, they have a very different feel to them. It's not me feeling that my thoughts are going about the place. It is me thinking, no, that's come from somewhere else. It's as if I am being shown images of the future. And that is exactly what is happening. So I do write down these prophetic dreams in a dream diary. I might dream of, say, I'm sitting around the kitchen table with certain people and we're eating a certain type of cake. And that is what I'll dream. So it's not very interesting, apart from, to me, which is absolutely fascinating. Hence why I write it down. When they do come true, I'm often able to go to my dream diary, look them up and think, it wasn't a déjà vu, because I often have a déjà vu feeling and then I remember, actually no, I've dreamt it, it's not a déjà vu, I actually dreamt it, which is why it feels to me like a déjà vu. And this is the reason why I started doing this, and I've done it for many, many years. I also take note if I have had a nightmare. Now nightmares are when you have gone out, generally, into the astral plane, you know, at night, you cast out from your body, you're doing that astral projection, and you are attacked by negative entities, bad jujus, demons, call them what you like. And if I have had a nightmare, it means that I have been attacked that night. A word about nightmares. Nightmares in general are symptoms that you are being attacked astrally. Unless you have suffered severe trauma, physical and mental trauma, you will get nightmares from those. But if you're just having nightmares, that's because you're being astrally attacked. There is a story I wish to tell you. A few years ago, I was called in to help this girl with her family. She lived in an old house in Devon and her little boy was having nightmares and wetting the bed. She'd asked a medium to come to her house and the medium had gone up to her second floor, to where the boy's bedroom was, and had run out of the house saying, I can't stay in here, it's too scary. Anyway, so she asked me, and you may or may not know that one of my jobs is as a demon banisher. So I went to this house, and found exactly that there was this pretty nasty entity hanging about in it. So we got rid of him and we put up some protection around the whole house. And lo and behold, her little boy stopped immediately from that night having nightmares, wetting the bed and waking up, because he wasn't being astrally attacked anymore. So having dealt with what my dreams are or how I've been dreaming, my next port of call is to pick up my pendulum. The reason why I do this, and it's pretty much immediately, is to check that A, I haven't brought any bad jujus back with me. So I will ask, you know, pendulum, is everything okay? And I get the forward and back motion, meaning yes it is, or I'll get a side to side motion, meaning no it's not. If it's not, I know that then I have to do stuff and I have to do it immediately. Now, I might not have brought a negative entity back into my house or into my garden because I have so many wards, but I often bring them back to just outside because they can't get in. And they'll sit there going, oh, this is exciting. The more you commune with the spirit world and spirit guides or earth entities or anything, the more your aura will reflect this and the higher your energy will become. And this, therefore, is more attractive to a demonic entity. So that is why I will always ask, especially after a nightmare, is all okay? So having asked my pendulum if everything okay, found out that it's not, I then will have this conversation with some spirit guides. So I immediately do some spirit work, ask them to come through, and we'll have a chat about what went on last night, where those demonic entities are now, what I need to do about them. Most of the time, because of the protection I have around my property and around my home, I just need to do a bit of work on my aura, because when you are attacked, your aura gets sort of knocked sideways and you get out of sync with your own body. Your body and your aura are sort of out of sync together. And so therefore, this can be very easily put back. Now, all of this before 6:30 in the morning is quite a lot to deal with. I mean, you know, checking out whether I've been attacked in the night, whether I need to deal anything to them, whether I need help with banishing and doing spirit work. And so therefore, this is one of the reasons I wake up so early, is because then I can give myself a little bit of me time just to heal if my aura's been put out or whatever. So my next job will be to find out how, and this is where, again, I will use my pendulum to ask if I need, for example, a smudge. Quite often I do need a smudge, so a little smudging ritual, either charcoal burner or a sage or with a joss stick, I will do then. However, I might well need some further support, and by this I mean I might need to hold some crystals in order to keep my aura in balance with my body, because I sometimes find that I've been knocked off kilter. And this is very easily done. I will just douse for them using my trusty pendulum. And here is how I do it. I will divide the crystals into two sections and then ask the pendulum whether this section is going to have the crystals that I need. It doesn't, so I split the piles again. I will continue in this fashion until I have discovered exactly which crystals it is that I am going to require to help me heal. In this instance, you can see I require two crystals. I require the tiger's eye and the Christ collar crystal. And now it is simply a matter of holding the crystals in the palms of my hands and using their healing energy to put myself back on track. Now, this still might not be enough support for me, so often I will drink a specialist cup of tea. I often go out in the morning and pick whatever the flowers are growing, and this morning I found some cleavers and some dandelions, and so therefore I'm going to make a cleaver dandelion and woodruff tea. The cleavers have a strong protective quality to them, perfect for this situation, and the dandelions give you added enthusiasm, brightness and joy. I only use the flowers of the dandelion because I find the stalks and the sepals a bit bitter. To this mixture, I'm also going to add a teaspoon of sweet rudruff, which will bring me magical joy and help me on my healing path. Finally, after drinking tea, if there's still spirits hanging about, I will often speak with the spirits who are around me and ask them how they wish me to help them or they help me. And this is when I might take some cards and look at tarot or playing cards in order to see what the spirits say. It's getting quite late normally at this point, and I have to get my family out of bed, feed them, give them breakfast and get them off to school. So I sort of stop. The weekend, this witchy morning routine can go on for a couple of hours. You know, I can do much more spirit work because I've got much more time, and I can do much more looking at the situation that's around or anything that I might need to do, because I do like to make sure that I have cared for all of my family members. And caring for my family members can involve quite a bit of magic. So that is my witchy morning routine, and it is what it is. Please leave me a comment if you're going to do any of this or if you believe it. I would love you to leave me a comment anyway, because that is how you show YouTube that you like my channel. So I'd be extremely grateful if you could just write hello Ginny or whatever, but I would be interested to know what you think of my morning routine. I hope you enjoyed this video and don't think I'm too insane, and I will see you next week.